everyone. My name is Charlotte Gonzalez, and I'm here today to continue writing our realistic fiction piece. I'm going to teach you a little something about zooming in on a moment and then telling it bit by bit so that our reader really feels like they're right there in the situation. This works for realistic fiction. It also works for other genres, like personal narrative, so stories that you tell that happened in your own life. We happen to be writing stories that could happen in real life, and this is another technique that can help you. So, when you're thinking about this, you want to maybe reread your piece or reread a part of your piece and decide which part is most important. The most important. Actually, which part is going to be really essential? That means which part might the reader really need to focus in on so they get the idea of what characters are like, or if the setting is changing, or if the character is kind of starting to learn something. So you want to zoom on that most important part and then tell that part bit by bit and then try to write that part. So when you're trying to zoom in and you're deciding, is this important or not? Then that's when you want to get rid of something that doesn't really help the story go on. So first, I'm going to kind of show you what I mean with a part in Enemy Pie, a book that some of us know really well. I know it well, and it can help me think about how an author like Derek Munson did this in his book. There is a part in here where the boy, we don't know his name, he's narrating the story, but we don't know his name. He is inviting who he thought was his enemy, Jeremy Ross, into his treehouse. Jeremy really wants to go in the treehouse, but earlier in the story, the boy was thinking that Jeremy was not very nice, and in fact he was making this enemy list that he put up in his treehouse. And now for the first time, Jeremy is going to go up in the treehouse, and the boy still has that list up. He knows that would be very offensive and hurt Jeremy Ross's feelings. So watch this. I think Derek Munson kind of zoomed in on this moment, and he's kind of sharing with us how the boy was thinking in his head. So the boy is thinking, well, my treehouse was my treehouse. I was the boss. If my sister wanted in, I didn't have to let her in. If my dad wanted in, I didn't have to let him in. And if Jeremy wanted in, can we go in it? Jeremy asked. I knew he was going to ask me that. But he was the top person, the only person on my enemy list. And enemies aren't allowed in my treehouse. But he did teach me to throw a boomerang. And he did have me over for lunch. And he did let me play on his trampoline. He wasn't being a very good enemy. Okay, I said. But hold on. Okay. So, to me, that's a part where the author is zooming in on the boy's thinking. So you can zoom in on that part and tell it bit by bit. Oh, but wait a second. He did let me jump on his trampoline. He did have me over for lunch. He's kind of thinking like, maybe he's not so bad, but he still has that list in his treehouse and he doesn't want Jeremy to see it. So to me, that was a part that Derek Munson zoomed in and let us know bit by bit what was happening in the boy's thinking. And that was really important for us to know because it shows us that the boy is starting to change his mind about Jeremy Ross. Maybe he's not such a bad guy after all. Maybe he's actually really pretty nice. So I was thinking about my own story, and I'm thinking I need to zoom in on a moment when my character Carla is really kind of struggling with what to do in a very difficult situation. She's really struggling if she's going to tell on her little cousin David and this mess that he made, or if she's not going to do that. So originally, I just had that Carla was wondering what to do. And now I think I'm going to say it something like this. As Carla was still trying to decide what to do, she just sat there, silent. She was still torn about what to do or say. She wanted to tell Uncle Pete the truth so badly, but she felt stuck. It was such an uncomfortable feeling. She had a pit in her stomach, her tongue was tied, and she was wringing her hands. So that's the part where I want the reader to really understand that Carla is having a hard time with this decision that she's trying to make, to tell her Uncle Pete the truth or not about this mess that her cousin Daniel had done. So that's a part that I want to zoom in on. Okay. As you're thinking about your story, find those places where it makes most sense to give the reader a little more. And tell that part bit by bit, and just try writing it out. You might try a couple of different ways, and then decide which way you like the best. I hope this helps as you're trying to maybe revise your piece. And it can also work when you're drafting, when you're thinking about, which part should I put in and which part should I take out? Okay, give it a go. And I'll be looking forward to seeing you next time. Thanks. Bye-bye.